Welcome to Games from Folktales, a podcast that mixes historical research and tabletop role-playing settings. I'm your host, Timothy Ferguson. This week, The Wolf of Ironwood. This is a quick LibriVox recording to give us our monster of the month. We have a werewolf, a witch, and a Faustian bargain all mashed together. I wondered why I'd not seen this one before. Eleanor Smith Dampier was a translator for Danish sagas, so I thought perhaps I'd missed it because it's set in the area just north of the Ars Magica play space in Mythic Europe. Turns out, however, I was wrong. At the end of her series of translations, published as The Norse King's Bridal, she added a chapter of her own work, and this one is one of her originals. Arguably, it's set somewhere in Britain. Thanks to Kerry Adams and to her team for the recording.
The Wolf of Ironwood by Eleanor Mary Smith Dampier. Read for LibriVox.org by Kerry Adams. Ho, for the white of the withered bough and the red of the wrinkled leaf, Sir Arngrim sits in Ironwood, and his heart is filled with grief. The sun sinks down on Ironwood, blood red behind the trees. Sir Arngrim stares upon the sword that lies across his knees. O, my father died of death of blood, and my mother of wasting woe, and their spirits dwell in the rocky fell where the trees of ironwood grow. And still the guilt of the lifeblood spilt doth unavenged remain, and in the red of the wrinkled leaf I read my father's pain. Oh, the kings were three sailed o'er the sea to work us havoc and harm, and I see in the white of the wizened bough my mother's beckoning arm. Sir Arngrim stood with the sea beneath and the rocky fell behind, and there he saw three gallant ships that sailed before the wind. O, red of hand, they come to land with a host and a mighty horde, and how shall I wreck my father's death with the power of a single sword? When the writhen shadows in Ironwood grew long and the fading rim of the sun sank low behind the fell, the witchwife came to him. Now hearken to me, thou goodly knight, and if thou grant me grace, I'll work a spell shall serve thee well for love of thy fair young face. Oh, a maid am I from dawn till dusk, but by night of a magic rune, and a weird of woe, a wolf I go, O knights beneath the moon. Thou shalt slay three hosts in Ironwood, that the wolf her fill may feed. Then, as lover true, when the fight is done, shalt pay the maiden's meed. Sir Arngrim looked upon the witch, and her face was fair to see. He's plighted her troth on his knightly oath, and sealed it with kisses three. It was the first of the host came on with a rush of a roaring gale, but they might not stir the single sword that bit through bone and mail. Oh, half of the host at eve were slain, and half of the host were fled, and all night long in Ironwood the wolf howled o'er the dead. It was the second host came on as levin leaps from the sky, but they might not quell the witch's spell and the sword of Gramerai. Oh, half of the host at eve were fled, and half in their blood lay still, and all night long in Ironwood the wolf did feed her fill. It was the third of the host came on like the waves of a winter sea, but they broke on the sword as billows break where the hidden skerries be. Oh, half of the host at eve were slain, and half were fled away, and like the dead among the dead, in a swoon Sir Arngrim lay. The moon shone down on Ironwood above the trees so tall, and lo, the red and wrinkled leaves upon his face did fall, and lo, the shade of the withered bough across his face lay dim, and the wolf she leaped and seized and tore the warrior limb from limb. Ho, ho, for the red of the wrinkled leaf, his spirit has gone to dwell with the grimly ghosts of the ancient hosts that haunt the rocky fell. Ho, ho, for the white of the withered bough, the witch she wails full sore, and Ironwood, for that deed of blood, is accursed evermore.
Your saga may vary.